in by a letter I sent in July. So, I don't have a name for it. Midsummer dusk fades color from rosy desert sky. I'm suspended in this sterile hospital room where high-tech machines hold court, measuring fluids and pressure, heartbeats, respiration, and beeps and clicks. As my frail brother frantically asks, am I going to die? We lock eyes in that frozen moment, his face blurred in a fleeting shadow of the irrepressible little boy I furiously chased barefoot in the park into the echo of endless summer days. He longs to hear the chirp of crickets, wind sifting through the chimes, the song of birds in the pomegranate tree. He longs for the mundane and the magical. He yearns for the discordant melody of everyday life. There is no answer that will suffice, no platitudes or pearls of wisdom I can convey. Tears well and spill as we look away. Baby brother, not ready for the sweet forever. I squeeze your withered hand, fervently praying its peace you will find. Back and forth and around you go, bargaining with doctors who are supposed to know. I watch you grasp the straws of hope and dismiss the rest, insistent you must be ignorant. Confined to a prison bed, you spend your hours seeking comfort, begging for more time. We reach out with love for your despair. The sisters and brothers you once stung, standing by your side, offering solace. While in your troubled mind, you brilliantly weave grand scenarios, lost victories, sweet memories. In your broken body, you struggle to breathe. From your rueful soul, you call out for God.
Thank you.